Hi friends, welcome to Studies with John. Our today's topic is English 9th Standard 1.2 Asepnosis, the Swiss Family Robinson. We will learn this, it is a very good novel. We will learn many nice values from it. I will try my best to make you enjoy this novel, and also please like and subscribe my channel. It motivates me to make more videos. So, The Swiss Family Robinson is a well-known adventure novel that people of many countries have enjoyed for more than 200 years. It has also been made into graphic novels and films. This is a very good novel. It has been enjoyed by many of the peoples for more than 200 years. And also, it has been made into graphic novels and films. The novel written by the Swiss clergyman Johann David Wyss. Here, clergyman means plain priest, is not just an adventure. It aims at teaching young people values like self-reliance, determination, love for your family, cooperation, and prudent use of resources. Means it is not just a novel, it tells us many values. So, here are the mentioned values which can come as a question, then what does the novel aims at teaching young people? So the answer would be that it aims at teaching young people values like self-reliance, determination, love for your family, cooperation, and prudent use of resources. It has also good lessons relevant in natural sciences, good husbandry, and even mathematics. Some elements of the novel do stretch reality to a certain extent, means they are stretching the imagination such that we are feeling that it is reality, but we must consider that it is a work of fiction, means imagination, so that we must remember that it is just a work of fiction, means it's just a story, just an imagination, it's not a reality. We have to remember it. William, Elizabeth and their children had been traveling in a ship when the ship was caught in a great storm. The other passengers evacuated, means emptied or left out without them. So these are the characters, William, Elizabeth and their children. They were traveling in a ship and the other passengers had left out without them because the ship was caught in a great storm. The William and his family included the young children Fritz, Ernest, Jack and Franz. These are the name of his sons, were left to survive alone. They were left to survive alone on the ship. They weathered the great storm, waiting in the ship's hold. The ship survived the night and the family found themselves within sight of a tropical desert island. The ship survived that night and the family found themselves within a sight of, which is a phrase, means nearby, a tropical desert island. The next morning they decided to get to the island they could see beyond the reef. With much effort they constructed a vessel out of tubs. After they filled the tubs with food and ammunition, the important things that they need, and all other articles of value, they could safely carry. They sailed toward the island. Two dogs from the ship named Turk and Juno swam beside them. There were two dogs on the ship with them. They also came with them swimming. The ship's cargo of livestock, guns and powder, carpentry tools, books, a dissembled finance and provisions had also survived. These were the material that they were carrying. Here, pinnace means small boats attached to a ship. Over the next few days, William, the father, attached a floatable old kegs. Kegs means barrels, to one another and built a boat that curved around them. The family had landed successfully on the island. They set up a tent and softened the floor with armloads of grass they cut and spread to serve as their beds. They landed on the island and they started making the facilities that they are important for them to live on that island, as they don't know when they would be able to get out of them. They came to a grove of trees. One tree grew what looked like gourds. On its trunk, the father told Fritz, the gourds would make excellent bowls and spoons, and they cut them into various utensils. They found some gourds and they used them as utensils as they need for eating. After some days, Elizabeth informed William that she wanted the family to move to a safer place. Means Elizabeth wanted the family to move to a safer place. Their current camp was not only exposed means very open, and its opposite would be enclosed, but also very dry and hot. Their current camp was very open and also very dry and hot. It is very open, so many animals can attack them. And it is very dry and hot. If they built a house up in one of the large trees, they would be safe from jackals. Jackals is an animal. So she told them if they built a house up in a large tree, then the jackals would not be able to reach there. She described a perfect tree for the project, one whose trunk was nearly 40 feet in diameter. The branches were very long and extended straight out from the trunk, making them perfect platforms for a structure. Later, this is a description of the house, how it would be. We should remember it. It can be asked as a question. Later, when determining the height of the lowest branches, the father taught the boys geometry and how to use triangles to measure big objects. The father, when making the house, their home, second home, the father taught his sons geometry in that condition and also how to use triangles to measure big objects. See, they are using practically experiencing that knowledge. Later, when determining the height of the lowest branches, the father taught the boys geometry. He measured a defined distance from the trunk. Then he calculated angles using several measured rods, determining that the lowest branch was 30 feet off the ground. So he measured using rods the branches and determined that it is 30 feet off the ground. The man knotted. Knotted means to put a knot, a rope, at certain intervals and attach pieces of bamboo in each knot. He knotted the certain pieces of bamboo to make ladder. Thus, they created their ladder to go up to their house. Father returned to the beach and collected driftwood. Driftwood is used for building the ship and float on water. Thinking it would be perfect for building a sledge. A sledge is a basket-like inning on runners rather than wheels. Later, they used it to transport materials. They built a sledge using driftwood, which can be useful for them to transport materials from one place to another. Meanwhile, Elizabeth announced that the garden she had been tending was producing healthy plants. The mother, Elizabeth, is also doing a very good job. She is doing farming, which is very nice. That would help them a lot. That they need for food. So she announced that many healthy plants are growing. Corn, melons, pumpkins and cucumbers were already growing. These some are fruits and vegetables. The next day only the father and priest traveled to the woods exploring. Exploring means searching out and finding such exotic. Exotic means not belonging to our country. Plants as one with waxy fruit. It's like waxy fruit means with covered or like waxy type covering they have, which candles could be made. And that waxy fruits, we can use this candle, that waxy covering. Fritz discovered a tree exuding. Exuding means emitting a rubbery sap, from which his father claimed that they could make boots. Again, they discovered a rubbery sap emitting tree and they made boots from it. Thinking ahead of the next winter, Paddy decided to create a place safe from the elements, a strong stowage to spot to protect themselves and their belongings. Now, the winter was coming, so now they have to make a new home because they have to be saved from the cold. So Fritz came up with the idea of a cave. Cave would be very nice for them to save. Not finding one, they thought of carving out their own cave in the rock, abutting their camping site. Abutting means having common boundary. So they decided not to find a cave in the island. They will make their own cave on the smooth face of the rock. Father marked the dimensions for an opening and they picked away at the hard face with their axes, chisels, hammers and shovels. These are the materials they used for making the cave. Over the next several days, the family cut windows in the rocks to allow for cross currents of air and for sunlight to enter the cave. They made some windows so that the sunlight and the air can freely come inside the cave, or else it would be hard for them to survive. When they had finished, they had four rooms complete with a fireplace. Fireplace means they would have kept a place where they would blow fire for light. They now had a new winter home. Then now they made a new winter home. This was their third house. First, there was very open. Second, they changed to a very big tree. Now third, in a cave. Here I am stopping the story. Now we will do some questions till now story. Here in the textbook they have mentioned that questions. In what way is a perk of fiction different from a fact file? Means a fact file is reality and work of fiction is imagination. It is different in that way. How did the family reach the tropical island? The family reached very successfully after the ship survived the night and the family found themselves within a sight. The next morning they had decided to get to that island, and with much effort they made some vessels, and they over the next few days they started and reached that island. Some more questions. Why did mother wish to shift the family to a tree house? Because their current camp was not only exposed but also very hot and dry, and it was not safe. Next, how did the mother occupy herself while the house was being built? She occupied her time while farming many plants such as corn, melons, egg, pumpkins and cucumbers were already growing. What was the third place the family decided to reside in? Why did they wish to shift there? The third place was a cave they decided to reside in. Why did they wish to shift there? Because the winters were coming and they need to go to a warmer place. I am ending this lecture here only. We will continue this story in next lecture and also do some other part. Please like and subscribe. Any doubts, put in the comment section.